from Design Squad Global.
And I'm here at 826 Boston, a place where kids can come to become great writers. Today, Kelly and Samaya from 826 Boston are teaming up with Zoe and Eleanor from Design Squad to create a personal reading pod, a quiet place where kids can go to read and dream.
The first thing we need to do is interview the kids at 826 to understand what their design needs are.
It would be easier to eat our snacks in the literacy pod if we have a cup holder.
We'll love a bookshelf because then the books will be right in the pod.
We should have a beanbag to make it really comfy.
A light would be good because it's going to be very dark in there.
Awesome! But remember, our pod is a very small space, so you have to be creative in how you make everything fit.
Our challenge is to reuse cardboard that we have at 826 Boston to create a reading pod that is easy to move and doesn't need electricity.
This has to be taped down to the bottom piece.
We used two cardboard boxes to make a bookshelf, and we cut a hole on the inside. And since the space was limited inside, we decided to put the bookshelves outside. And here's our bookcase.
Okay. Do we want to do it this way?
This will be like a miniature house.
We created a sliding door on track so that it would move.
Cardboard strips on the top and bottom create channels, holding the door in place so it can slide back and forth.
We put the handle like this so that you can move it from outside and inside.
For a seat inside the reading pod, the team created a beanbag chair out of packing peanuts.
And that's the beanbag chair.
Now that our reading pod has a fun way to get in and out, a place to stash our books, and a comfy seat, we need a way to brighten up the inside without using electricity.
We're creating skylights out of plastic bottles of water.
We're going to put the skylights in the shape of a seat to look like a crescent moon.
This is the darkest part of the pod, so we're going to cut holes in the ceiling and put the skylights here.
The light from outside the pod enters the bottle and the water refracts the light, spreading it in all directions, which means it's omnidirectional. Lights like these are being used in countries where electricity is not readily available. They're making a big difference for people who wouldn't otherwise have light in their homes.
Okay, we need scissors stacked. Turn it like this,
and then cover
the top, see?
Put the side off.
Cup holder!
And now it's time to show the rest of 826 Boston our finished reading pod.
I like the beanbag chair in it, and I like the bookshelf, and I really like the part how the water, the light is reflecting from that. I think it's really creative, and it's cool.
We did it! We got creative, and we worked together. Another success for Design Squad Global.
Yay!
Send your designs for your reading pod to the Design Squad Global website and see what different ideas you can come up with.